The horse's back swings up and down in walk and trot. In canter, mm-hmm. it goes this way. The human spine has four curves, and these two forces got to come together somehow. Let's look at the saddle tree of a saddle. So this is sort of the modern tree, okay? So that is the interior of a saddle. Here you got the old-fashioned trees. Some trees are still using them. You can get companies who make saddles for under $500 on those trees, some over $7,000, depends what leather, what company. And the ultra-modern tree is a combination of English and Western, so really narrow for the rider here where the black rails are, mm-hmm. and really, really wide for the horse, so the saddle has more weight-bearing surface. Now, the most important part, no matter what tree you buy, is the actual part what goes under the tree, in here what we call the gullet plate. So this plate, many saddles have different ideas of how this plate should look. Mm-hmm. Some plates are straight, some plates are forward, and some plates are curved and go back. Modern saddle trees, unfortunately, very often forget that if we look at the shoulder blade of the horse, right here where you see the damage in the shoulder blade, most of the time from saddle trees, which have very short tree points, and are pointing forward, and when the horse moves, big problems. If you look at the Western saddles or army saddles or tree points but face back, that's the whole idea, so the shoulder doesn't hit the metal. Mm-hmm. So back to the original question. So wider the tree needs to be here. So that these corners need to really open up, but the side need to wrap around the side of the, let's call it a horse with a very, very wide flat withers, wide barrel, okay, that needs to wrap around the bell. Otherwise it goes from side to side. So if you have a short plate, you have absolutely no chance to fit that saddle because it just rolls from side to side. If you have the proper plate, what goes backwards, what is long enough to open all the way around and then come nicely around the horse. A good example is my son-in-law's head. He has a helmet. When I put his helmet on, I can't watch. I can't see because the helmet slides all the way down in my face. He has a very wide head. So his helmet, the width is very wide. But his helmet, the sides, they don't flare out like a sombrero. They're fit aligned on the side. So to answer the question, it is very straightforward to fit a Friesian or any horse with a very wide back, so long the tree point is long enough and curved back from this curve, and the most important part, and the long the saddle is not too close to the horse's ride. The rider sits a little higher. It's very easy. I need to turn off that screen sharing again. When we stand up, and let's say this is the pelvis of, yep, that's a female pelvis. And the legs are attached like my arms in the hip socket. That hip socket goes this way. Your thighs can go to the side, but on the end of the thigh, where my elbow is the human's knee. And just like my elbow, it only moves this way. Mm-hmm. Okay, so if you want to get your leg, like my arm, this is your thigh. Mm-hmm. The lower part of my arm is your lower leg. If you want it to be around the horse's body, if you sit very, very close, your leg sticks out, or your toe sticks out so much that you can't gallop or do the posting trot. You will hurt your hip and your knee tremendously. If you sit a little higher on that very, very wide horse, Your hips will not kill you. Your lower leg will be on the horse. And you will have a very nice contact and easy to do your rising trot. A good example is if you sit on an oil barrel without anything, try to put your knees and toes forward. Or try to get your leg underneath you. If you put one or two pillows between your bottom and the oil barrel, you sit a little higher of that oil barrel, and that oil barrel becomes a little bit more oval, and now it's easy on your hip, on your legs, and you're not disrupting your movement in your back. First I was showing you is the movement in the horse's spine and the human spine. If your leg and hips hurt, you fall back into the, we know that as chair seat, and you will hurt not only your back, but you will hurt the horse's back because your toes and knees are out and you have no shock absorption.